A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day, I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, whoever wishes to come after me must deny themselves, take up his cross, and follow me. Whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then will be repaid according to all his conduct. The Gospel of the Lord. You know, we have many tools at our disposal. If we think about it, silverware. Where would we be without silverware? How could you cut your meat? How could you eat your dinner? I guess you could do like I do. Just eat it that way with the fingers. Where would you be without your kitchen stove? How can you cook your food? Where would you be without your garden shovel? How could you dig holes in the ground? But probably the most important one is, where would you be without your microwave? I am sure the guys are saying, probably without dinner. Wives are going, yeah, it wouldn't be bad. But there's other tools that we have at our disposals every day that we use rarely, most importantly. That's our words, the way we communicate to each other. These words are used to convey a thought to someone, to convince someone of something, to share information with someone, to have that person feel the way you do. Words can be happy, such as, I love you. Words could add drastic things to it, depending on what word you use. All of us know words that we like hearing. Think about it for a second. What's the most important word to you? Maybe I love you. Maybe I'm sorry. I've said a lot of those in my time. 47 years ago, I was standing on the steps of the church, nervous as heck, and comes my bride walking down the aisle in a dress. And there was two words that I remember so vividly that changed my life, changed her life. See, when we saw those words to each other, we were talking to God. We said the words, I do. The words I do changed us. See, they entered us into a lifelong covenant between me and Debbie, my wife, and us and God. A covenant so strong that it cannot be broken, never broken. It means that we'll be with each other forever. It means that we now have to worry about each other, share each other's life. and do the best we can for each other. Well, in the Gospels, the last 2 weeks, we've heard a lot of words as we normally do. But let's step back for a second on last week's Gospel. What did Jesus call Peter? A rock? Did he say, Peter, you are a rock, and upon you I will build my church? That's what he said. Imagine what Peter felt like. I'm the Pope. I'm going to build a church on me. I can do what I want, wear that funny hat. But I'm the Pope. I'm the keeper of the keys to heaven. What did that do for Peter? How did he feel? Then this week, what do we hear in the Gospel? Get behind me, Satan. What changed? What changed from calling him a rock to get behind me, Satan? There wasn't that much in the Bible, maybe a couple verses. See, what changed is this. It affects all of us. It's called Christian paradox. All of us commit to be Christians. We want to be good Christians. We want to save the world. We want to help everybody. Right? We all want to do that, correct? We're all there. Sure, let's sign me up for it. But what happens when I say, you got to do this? Such as carrying your cross. A cross can be simple as this. It could be a disappointment in your life. But it could mean more than that. It could be a failure. It could be loss of a dear friend, someone you loved. It could be health, your health. It could be something that you're going to question the Lord, why is it happening to me? But that's your cross. Now, are you willing to be a Christian carrying your cross? That's the paradox. Christianity, we said, tell everybody, it's the greatest thing in the world. But take the words we heard today, and we hear Jesus talking, try to influence Peter. He was telling Peter to stop thinking like a human. Okay? Start thinking as God does. To stand behind Jesus. Follow Jesus' example. Then he can show people how to get to heaven. Amen.